Hi, I'm Roxy. Welcome back to my channel. All right, sorry for the mess. I've just been trying to reorganize my area. So I'm doing something different. I was actually drawn to use two different decks. So as you can see, I got two different decks going. And at first I got the fact that you are one. You're gonna have two different people, two different energies. Take it as it resonates. Love, life, work, whatever. But I feel like somebody has two different types of options, because there's like this King of Wands at the top, but there's also this King of Pentacles beside this person. And the way these are laid out, like at first that's what I got, but then I also got another message, the fact that this is, one of them is you, this King of Wands, and the other one is this King of Pentacles. And you guys have been through some shit, and it's kind of similar, but not quite. Like, you both are holding back for whatever reason, and you both feel like this could be a Ten of Cups situation. Ace of Cups is behind that, but there's some type of illusion. This person's holding back for whatever reason. They might have two other people that they're dealing with, or they got something else that's blocking them from coming towards you. They feel hurt the fact that they have to sit there and watch you and not be truthful about how they truly feel. The fact that they're away from you really puts them up in their head. Whatever is stopping them. Like, it doesn't even have to be a person. Like, there's a person right here, but your person's sorrow. Like, they're in sorrow. They want to send messages to you, but they can't. They might even be a little cold to you right now. And there's nothing really growing from this connection, even though somebody or both of you feel like this could be a, or maybe this is your side. Like, you feel like this could turn into an Ace of Cups, a new beginning, but somebody else is fretting this because you got the Ace of Cups on your side, but this person has the Death card on their side. But that doesn't have to mean that's a bad thing. Like I said, and then you get the Hermit right here with also feeling stuck and holding back what they really truly want to be, who they really truly want to be. They really want to be this King of Rods, King of Wands. They really want to be very passionate. So like the two of you are kind of mirroring each other, but you guys are also holding back from coming forward towards each other as well. But I feel like this ending, it had to happen. So there's an ending happening, and it could be the fact that this person is no longer holding back. They're no longer sitting here calming themselves or keeping their this big whatever this is right here, this strength, this beast. They're slaying this beast. Like, she's like snapping the head off of this beast. Whatever this is that is holding this person back from you, this person is working on this. Like, this is being betrayed as the Tower moment right there. So I feel like there's some type of ending, some type of transformation that's going to happen from all of this. And it's actually going to be very beautiful, because after that, this person is, like I said, working on this Tower moment of theirs. They could be working on some type of money. They might even come in truthfully the fact that they have been working their ass off right now, even though they want to come in and be very passionate. And I heard Tiki for a ride. So this person really wants to come in and be with you. But like I said, there's some other things that have to happen before, and it's on both sides. So I feel like the both of you, like I said, are mirroring each other for the most part. Not completely, but I still feel like you both have some ish, because there's like a lot. Like, this is the two of you right here. Like, you're trying to come together, but there's this thing that's in between the two of you. Like, you want to take a leap of faith with this person. You want to come in and give them all this cup of love, all this emotion. But again, like I said, there's something stopping you and keeping yourself back. Someone's very, very worried. This is the other side. Like, you're worried. You manifested this, though. And this could have been a past life person. Like, these all feel like these are different lies behind you, and you're just kind of scared. But even though you're scared, you're also kind of confused. Like, did I really manifest something that I've been wanting for a long time? Is this even possible? Some of you feel like this person that comes into your life, if you haven't met this person yet, you're going to feel like you're being revived. Like, for whatever reason, I feel like this person's been laid to rest. But for whatever reason, I'm feeling like this is a good thing. Like, this person feels like they can lay down their swords and they don't have to fight for you or with you. Like, a lot of the conflict is, like, being laid down. Like, this person has been through a lot of shit. They've always feel like they need to fight for what's theirs. They always need to They're always fighting for what's theirs. This person might have had, I heard, played with others. So this person might have been with a past person that was seeing other people, that kept them in this state of mind of feeling like I'm not good enough to keep this person around. And this person is stuck because of this. But like, when they find, I feel like when they meet you, they're something, like I said, they're really up in their head. They're really scared to come out of this, in case you didn't know. Like, this person's been through a lot, and they're really up in their head about a lot of things. They overthink the situation far more than they probably should, and they probably don't need to. But this person's in that healing process right now. They still feel like, they need to hide you away from the world so that no one else can see you. Because if somebody else sees you, then that's a chance of somebody else taking you from them. Again, so if you have a lot of options, this scares this person away. They don't like competition. Like I said, they don't like the fact that they might have this possibility of losing you. They have that what if going on in their mind right now. Their thoughts are where really, I heard, overweighing their mind. Like, it's very heavy. They need to leave this overthinking in the past, because it really is, it has them in this grieving stage, even though they don't need to be in this grieving stage. Like, they have their Nine of Cups sitting right there in front of them. Like, you're, some of you, you might even be very abstinent. Like, you want to keep offering this person something, but they're not taking your cups. Like, you've made quite a few advances, you've tried to come towards this person, but they seem to not accept your cup like you would hope they would. Like, they just feel like this cup is too good to be true. There's got to be something around this cup that it just is too good to be true, and this person needs to put an ending to that. But I feel like they might even be watching you, whatever it is that they're doing. And I feel like this is also helping them heal, because like I said, they've had some fuckery is what I heard in the past, and this is really what keeps them moving forward with you. This person doesn't want to watch and wait anymore though. They want to run in and like claim you. Like, this person is running in with a stick running in his hand. Like, they want to run away from whatever ish they get going towards them. I heard freeing. Very soon this person's going to be coming towards you, because I feel like something is releasing them, or they're being released by something. I heard clutches. So the something, whatever this dark days, this is over with. This person's being released from whatever shit that's been going on, and they're going to be coming in very passionately. Or when you meet this person, it's going to take a little bit to get this person to really come around, because they are so damn guarded. But when they meet you and they realize, and you cut all this bullshit out, they're going to realize that there is, you're not one of those people who are for everyone. You're like, you're not everybody's cup of tea. And this is what's going to, this person's going to be watching this play out. And this person's going to really realize that you're not that type of person they need to worry about. And this is what's going to make them feel so freeing. This person's realizing that you are actually going to pour, I heard, just their cup. So this is a big thing for them. 911 is, was just on there for a time. That might be something for you. Like, this person knows that you're gonna pour into their cup, and they're no longer in this hurt stage, this overthinking. They're gonna start to put their hand out and accept this cup. But like I said, they're very skittish. You kind of have to come at them really gently, so to speak. Like, you really gotta work on this person. This person really wants you to fight for them. Like, they don't want to be just giving their cup away to just anybody. So if you're not out here trying to win them over or trace after them, they don't want anything to do with it. But I feel like that's kind of like a kitty energy. Like it's kind of, I don't want to like be mean about it, but like this person's definitely trying to get, like they're in the runner chaser right now. They want you to chase them. They want to feel like they're worth something as well. Or maybe this is you. Take it as it resonates. Someone needs to put their hands down and stop being in this fighting mode. Like, you don't always need to have your hands up to fight. Like, put your hands down. It's time to stop fighting. This is not the one you need to fight with. You're fighting with your... This is not your opponent. This is actually player number two. So stop trying to fight this person off. This is your teammate. Tag team is what I heard. Like, stop fighting this person. Something's going to grow out of this ending. That these death that you've had in the past, this is all to get you to this point in your life. To put you on the right path to be with this person. Stop fighting. This is it. This is your person right here. This is the person that you're going to grow with. Like, stop fighting them. You don't need to have your hands up anymore. You're not in the ring anymore. Put your hands down. For whatever reason, I keep hearing, put your hands down. I said that accidentally in one of my other readings, too. And now I realize, like, it's so funny because sometimes I'll go back and, like, I'll watch some of my readings that I do. And it's just like, okay, I know what that meant now, but I didn't even correspond with it when I was doing that reading. I just feel like somebody has, like, this. Like, that they just have their hands up ready to fight, but it's to the wrong person. You don't need to feel like you need to battle this person. You're not in the battlefield anymore. Like, calm down. You're not out on the streets anymore. Like, calm down. This is not the person you want to fight. This is the person you want to work with. So stop fighting this person off. Some of you, like I said, you're very skittish to come in and you're so looking for a fight. It's almost like you're looking for a fight. Like, you're looking for this person to just up and leave you. If you go looking for this... Like, just the way this is being portrayed right here, like, you're seeing this, like, you're blocking this person off, you're putting your swords up because you're ready to fight, and this is causing conflict within yourself, and you don't need to do that. You need to come in passionately. You don't need to fight. There's no reason to fight. Like, the gods is giving this to you, and you're fighting them off. Like, okay, I guess we're gonna have to stand... I heard sprawl, so... Or how do you... Whatever you say. I know I'm probably saying that wrong. Like, you're fighting off your good deeds. Like, you're fighting off with the gods or whoever you believe in. You're fighting off something that you've been praying for. This love, like, this even, like, resembles a heart. Like, you're overthinking this thing that's coming in. You think you have to fight, and you don't. Like, you need to put your sword down. It's time to put that sword down and walk away from the fight. You don't need to fight this one. This person's going to give you strength. Yeah, you got to walk away from this fighting. You're confusing someone by... constantly fighting off every cup, every advance that you give them. You being in this Queen of Swords energy and fighting off this person, all their advances, all their love, all their whatever it is that they're doing, they're hurt just like you. But this person's willing to put out their hand again. Whoo, energy. Every time you put this person puts their hand out, you're slapping it and like, okay, guess that's not what you want. And eventually, it's like your kids, when you like tap their hand and say no, eventually they're going to be like, okay, I shouldn't do that. So this person's going to walk away. Like, I feel like you're very emotional about this person, but yet you keep slapping their hand every time they come in or when this person comes in. This is going to be you or this person. And eventually someone's going to get sick and tired of getting their hand pushed away, that they're going to walk away and you're going to push away something that you've asked for. Yeah, don't be afraid to take me by the hand if you want to. Stop walking away from this. You know exactly what you want. If you don't want this, walk away. If you do, keep going. Accept that cup of love. Take it. Drink from it. It's yours. Love and light.